Hello everybody, I am Sandeep Chade from Department of Zoology, GS Gawande College, Umarkhed. Today we will deal with the concept of snake venom, including anatomy of snake bite, types and composition of snake venom, antivenom, first aid and associated myth, along with treatment and prevention of snake bite. Dear students, there are over 3000 species of snakes found on every continent except Antarctica, and there are about 270 plus species of snakes found in our India, out of which about 60 are highly venomous. The big four dangerous snakes of India include Indian cobra, crate, Brussels vipers and soft scale viper. Let's start with the question related with the snake venom. What is snake venom? Snake venom is a highly modified saliva containing zootoxins that facilitate the immobilization and digestion of prey and defense against threats. It is injected by unique tongue during bite, and some species are also able to spit their venom. There are four types of venom: cytotoxin, mycotoxin, hemotoxin and neurotoxin. Before going to know details about these different type of venom, let's try to understand the anatomy of snake bite. The anatomy of venomous snake is widely varied, but some aspects they are universal. All snakes have similar venom delivering apparatus system comprised of venom gland adapt with an accessory gland and fang for venom delivery. The venom gland are where venom is produced, and that consists of three major type of cells: basal cell, conical mitochondria rich cell and secretory cell. These secretory cells are known for production of venom. Venom production appears to be regulated by the gland itself, and it is independent of neural control, Kochwa, that determine that the gland contains some marrow sensitive or pressure sensitive cells, and that fluid pressure inside the gland was the main determinant in rate of venom production. Venom is carried from the gland to the fang by a duct that flows through an accessory gland. The accessory gland was noted by Mitchell to prevent wasteful flow of the secretion. This gland lacks smooth muscle and is thickly regulated by striated muscle. Implications are that the accessory gland is under voluntary control, and that snakes can do control the amount of venom that is released during a bite. Now, what is the composition of snake venom? Snake venom is not composed of single compound, but it is a complex mixture of proteins. It is not known exactly how many proteins are present in venom, but it probably consists of 50 to 60 different components. Each protein possesses its own biological activity. A further complication is that composition and activity of snake venom vary among these species. In general, the closer the phylogenetic relationship of the snake, the more similar are the venom properties and composition. Venom is made up of combination of proteins and enzymes. Proteins constitutes about 90 to 95% of venom's derivative, and they are responsible for almost all of its biological effects. Among hundreds, even thousands of proteins found in venom, there are toxins, neurotoxins in particular, as well as non-toxic proteins which also have pharmacological properties, and many enzymes, especially hydrolytic ones. Now, let's try to know more details about the enzymes which are present in these venom. Enzymes include phospholipases A and B, which causes hemolysis by lysing the phospholipid cell membrane of RBC. Phosphodiesterases, which interfere with the Peyer's cardiac system, mainly to lower blood pressure. Hyaluronidase, that increases tissue permeability to accelerate absorption of other enzymes into tissue. Then arginine ester hydrolysis, then collagenase, acetylcholine esterases, DNAs, RNAs, NAD nucleotidase, L-amino acid oxidase, procoagulants, anticoagulants. Compounds with low molecular weight up to 1.5 kilodalton includes metals, peptides, lipids, nucleosides, carbohydrates, amines, and oligopeptides, which inhibit angiotensin converting enzyme, that is ACE, and potentiate bradykinin, that is BPP. So, some snake venom carry fasciculins like the mammals, which inhibit cholinesterase to make the prey lose muscle control. Now we will see some immediate symptoms of cytotoxic mycotoxic venom, which is excreted by rattlesnake, lance-headed viper, and pup adder-like snake. The symptoms include intense local pain, gradual swelling, nausea and vomiting, distinct metallic taste, loss of consciousness. Another one, that immediate symptoms of hemotoxin type of venom, which is generally excreted by temple viper, sand viper, or broom plant. The symptoms include severe headache and thirst, tissue swelling around the site of the bite caused by the hemorrhage, extreme pain, destruction of RBCs causing a lack of oxygen in the body, internal bleeding from major organs, and finally death. After that, certain immediate symptoms of neurotoxin venom, or that venom which is excreted by certain snake like Gabon viper, black mamba, excess coral snakes like poisonous snake. It is fast acting and rapidly attacking on the CNS, and that causes paralysis. Another symptom is respiratory failure, and finally death they occur. Now, what is the antivenom? Antivenom, also known as antivenin or venom antiserum, and also it is known as antivenom immunoglobulin. It is one of the medication made from the antibodies that is used to treat certain venomous bites and stings. Antivenom serum is injected into the body of the victim to counteract snake venom. Different antivenoms are required against different snakes. It is prepared by injecting horse with gradually increasing dose of snake venom until the horse becomes fully immunized. Then blood serum of horse is collected and preserved. It has developed antibodies to neutralize the effect of that particular snake venom. Now, let's try to understand about the first aid after the snake bite. At the time of snake bite, it is very essential to get emergency treatment as quickly as possible. However, there are some tips that you should keep in mind. Number one, note the time of bite. Second, keep calm and still, as movement can cause the venom to travel more quickly through the body. Third, remove constricting clothing or jewelry, because the area surrounding the bite will likely swell. Fourth, don't allow the victim to walk, carry or transport them by vehicle. Fifth, do not kill or handle the snake. Take a picture if you can, but don't waste time hunting it down. Now, certain myths are also associated with this first aid. There are also several outdated first aid techniques that are now believed to be unhelpful or even harmful, like do not use tourniquet, do not cut into the snake bite, do not use a cold compress on the bite, do not give person any medication unless directed by doctor, do not raise the area of the bite above the victim's heart, do not attempt to suck the venom out by mouth, do not use a pump suction device. These devices were formerly recommended for pumping out snake venom, but it's now believed that they are more likely to do harm than good. Now, let's know about the treatment for the snake bite. The most important thing to do for a snake bite is to get emergency medical help as soon as possible. A doctor will evaluate the particular victim to decide on a specific course of treatment. In some cases, a bite from a venomous snake is not life-threatening, and the severity depends on the location of the bite and the age and health of the victim. If the bite is not serious, the doctor may simply clean the wound and give the victim a tetanus vaccine. If the situation is life-threatening, the doctor may administer antivenom. This is a substance created with snake venom to counter the snake bite symptoms. It is injected into the victim. The sooner the antivenom is used, the more effective it will be. Now, certain preventions we should take to avoid the snake bite. Snake bites can be prevented in many cases. It is best to refrain from approaching or handling snakes in the wild. Avoid typical places where snakes like to hide, such as patches of tall grasses and field leaves and rocks and wood piles. If you encounter a snake, give it a space to retreat and let it take cover. It's in the snake's nature to avoid interaction. When working outside, where snakes may be present, wear tall boots, long pants and leather gloves. Avoid working outside during night weather, which is when snakes are most active. So friends, I hope you understand the concept of snake venom very well. If you have any queries regarding with the same aspect, then write that queries in the comment box. If you like my presentation, then please do like it, because your one like can motivate me for the next effort. Thank you so much, and do take good care of yourself. Thank you.